family, what's going on? It's your boy Dylan Flex. Yes, guys, we back at it again with another video. Yes, we doing daily uploads. A lot of you were like, I can't believe it, he's daily uploading. Yes, we back at it again and we are better than ever. I wanted to do a special video today for you guys. So my DMs have been consistent of a lot of questions, right? And I'm gonna break it down for a lot of you beginner resellers and even people that wanna learn more about reselling, right? So this video is gonna consist of 5 tips on beginning reselling, right? So this is 5 tips I personally think that you guys would enjoy. Also, it's gonna help you make money and it's gonna help you in the long run. So without further ado, let's jump into it. So first and foremost, I have a lot of questions. Dylan, how do I know when a shoe is releasing? What shoe is hype that's releasing? Where can I find it? What can I do? I wanna get pairs for retail. Yes, very good question. Everybody wants to get stuff for retail, right? What I can recommend if you don't have, which I'm sure a lot of you do, but if you don't, I would recommend a couple things. This is just a couple, there's a ton. I'm just gonna list a couple. First and foremost, like I said, you have to have the sneakers app, right? So the sneakers app's always updating you and telling you what shoes are releasing that you can get for retail. I would have my notifications on so I know what shoe is gonna release and when and how do I enter. Another easy way, and this is something I do as well, is Yeezy Mafia, right? So when it comes to Yeezys, Yeezy Mafia on Twitter is always tweeting out when a shoe's dropping, how to get it, what the price is gonna be. Simple stuff like that makes it very easy for you to get a pair of shoes for retail. And that's a lot of people's goal, right? They're always asking, how do you get so many pairs of shoes? What do you do? Well, you have to do the basic things first before you can get into the extreme stuff, right? So that's one of the ways that I get stuff for retail, right? So it's simple, it's easy, don't be lazy. It takes a couple minutes to look up certain things. That's number one. Another question I get DM'd and asked a ton is, Dylan, so I have the shoe, how do I sell it? Okay, that's a very good question as well. There's a couple different ways you can go about this. If you're a beginner and you're a reseller and you don't maybe have a following or you don't wanna meet up with people, which is understandable, or you're just not comfortable doing certain things, right? I personally would sell on apps. That's how I started, right? Goat, StockX, Grailed, eBay are all great places to literally not deal with people and just ship right to them, right? Ship right to the app. The pandemic's been crazy and StockX and Goat, I've been hearing from people are not paying and it's been an issue and a hard time getting your money. I want my money fast and now and I don't wanna deal with the fees, right? I would start my own website, my own Instagram. But that's simple and easy ways to sell the shoe immediately, right? And not have to deal with anybody. Those apps are good. If you have new stuff, you can go on StockX. If you have new and used, you can go on Goat. So those are easy ways to get your money back from shoes, right? So number three, this is something that I talk about all the time. And if you guys have followed my videos and have seen me talk about this, you're gonna be like, I already know what this is, right? I would not get high on my own supply. Now that does not mean I wouldn't buy personals, right? So what I'm saying is, don't make every single one of those sizes that come in a personal shoe. I would make sure that I'm constantly trying to sell, reinvesting in my business, right? And flipping and keeping it moving. It's very easy to get caught up in a shoe that just dropped. Oh my God, I have to have this, right? And there's nothing wrong with buying shoes for personals. I have a bunch of personal shoes, but not every single shoe do I have to have a personal of, right? Especially if you're trying to resell and make money. If you wanna pay for your shoe, guys, I understand. That's awesome. Pay for your shoe, that's essentially actually how I started. I would buy shoes and then I would have it pay for my other shoes, right? So my shoe was free essentially. It was perfect. But when you wanna scale it to a higher end and you wanna make real money selling shoes, you can't always keep a bunch of your personals, right? I think in moderation, I would not do it so you literally have no inventory, right? That's just a tip that I have personally that's worked out really well for me. Another tip I have for beginners and resellers, this is a huge one. This isn't just in reselling, this is in life and this is in business. I wouldn't burn bridges and I would keep my relationship strong with people. Now, what does that mean exactly, right? Don't club people over the head when it comes to prices, right? You do not have to get rich off one shoe. If someone's offering you something that's extremely fair, right? Depending on what you bought it for, that $10 or $20 down the road is really not gonna mean anything if your relationship's strong with them, right? Relationships and plugs that you have with people can open doors that in the long run, that $10, $20, let's just say $100, right? will not mean anything. So I wouldn't beat people up over prices when it comes to that. Keep your relationship strong. I think that's one of the main things. Like I said, not even for business, that's just for life. Don't burn bridges with people, guys. I know a lot of people, especially when it comes to shoes, have really, really bad reputation. And it's just not necessary. You don't have to do that. So if you're a beginner, guys, keep your relationship strong and do the right thing. So this is one that I have that I get asked probably every single day, right? If something is too good to be true, most of the time it's too good to be true, right? I have a lot of questions. Dylan, I want this Off-White. Do you think this is a good price? Guys, if the shoe's $100 and it's an Off-White, right? And it goes for way over market, 9 times out of 10, the shoe's a replica, right? So if something is too good to be true, like I said, guys, 9 times out of 10, it usually is. Do not believe and listen. It's very easy to get suckered in by some of these resellers. And this business especially is filled with a lot of scammers. And I don't want beginners to get a bad taste from the get-go on this, right? So if the shoe looks, sounds, feels too good to be true, guys, it is. Make smart decisions when it comes to buying, right? I get a lot of questions. Does this shoe look good, Dylan? Does this? And I always ask them, where's the shoe from? Like, what's the background? Who's the shoe from, right? Don't just buy from anybody when it comes to this, right? You don't want to tarnish your name off of one bad shoe. It was just a couple tips and tricks that I wanted to give you guys. Maybe you have heard this, maybe you haven't. It's just stuff that I think is extremely helpful in the long run when it comes to reselling sneakers and in business itself. This is just part one. I wanted to make a short video for you guys. I want to make sure you guys are following Capital Vegas for the steals and deals we have on there. Guys, it's been crazy. The website is Shop Dylan Flex. Make sure you guys check out the website. You know, one of the biggest questions I get asked is, are you doing mystery boxes? Yes, I try to do mystery boxes every day or every other day. Make sure you guys are DMing me on Capital Vegas and Dylan Flex. There's no other way to make 15 to 25% on your money back. Mystery boxes are amazing, guys, and I don't just put BS stuff in it. I appreciate all the love and the support from you guys. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next one. Man, I just wanna go fast. Hold on my teeth and on my neck.